Yeah.
That's a medical term.
Yeah, it is a medical term. Loose tongue.
Yeah. There's something in James about that, I think.
Yes, there is.
There's something in James about the tongue.
Yeah.
Well.
Well, it was, it's probably been about 10 years, maybe 8 years since. When was Danielle? Danielle was probably 12, our daughter, the last time we went camping. It was on a tent. We used to camp a lot when we were kids, when we were younger, when we first got married. And I just told Carol, when our daughter got married 2 years ago today, as a matter of fact, 2 years ago,
yeah,
I said, we're going to start camping again. And I just told her, but I'm not sleeping on the ground anymore.
All right, hold it right there. Hi, and welcome back. Today I'm in Highlands Hammock State Park, and I'm with Vernon and Carol.
Carol.
They're from North Carolina, the Outer Banks of North Carolina. Is that right?
That's where I'm from, yes. She's from Tampa.
Oh, you're from Tampa?
Yeah.
Did Claire tell you we lived there for a few years?
Yes, she did.
Yeah, where in Tampa?
All over in Tampa.
All over, okay.
Yeah, all over in Tampa.
Great. And they've agreed to show us this really unique... this is a cargo van that they converted, and let's go back to why you decided to get up off the ground.
Okay, we used to camp a lot when our daughter was younger, and we got out of service and came back to Tampa in 85.
Out of MacDill?
No, I was in the Army. We moved there, and we started camping a lot, and our daughter was born, and we camped a little bit with her, and then... now she's been gone 2 years, and it's been quite a while since we were camping, and I wanted to start camping again.
Okay.
And I told Carol that when we start camping, we're getting our butt off the ground. I'm too old to lay on the ground.
I know.
And sleep on the ground.
I know.
So we did some investigating. We went and looked at campers everywhere, and we looked at campers, and we're talking about getting a camper and getting off the ground, and I just... saw the prices of them and decided we need to do something different. We don't have a large income. We're just a one-family income.
Uh-huh.
And we're looking around trying to find some type of a floor plan to change a cargo trailer into a camper.
Yeah.
And I had figured this all out and got it all figured in my mind, how I wanted to lay the trailer out, what I wanted to do in it. She still wasn't on board with the idea.
Okay.
We went into Airstream, and one of their smallest campers they have has almost identical floor plan.
Oh, is that right?
That I decided. It's just not as elaborate. It's not as pretty. And it's a little shorter. Doesn't have a table in the front of it.
Yeah.
But when you go camping, you're supposed to be outside anyway.
Yeah.
Not inside.
Yeah, that's right.
So that was when... finally convinced her into, okay, we'll get a cargo trailer and do what you want to do.
Okay, cool. Now you did most of the work yourself.
I did all the work on the inside of it.
Do you have a background in metal work?
I am a carpenter by trade.
Oh, are you really?
Fell in 95 and was never able to go back to work.
Uh-huh.
So I did all the work on the inside of it. I just had to order the things that I couldn't do. The ramp door in the back, I didn't want that. I just wanted a smaller door in the back.
Uh-huh.
Didn't want it in the center. I wanted it off the side so that I could put an air conditioner in it.
Uh-huh.
Air conditioner was kind of expensive to put on the top. So I just put a little window unit in the back and made that one door on the side for access for cargo under the bed and emergency exit in case something went wrong.
Yeah.
And I ordered the trailer with the camper doors in it and the awning and the camper door on the side, and then I did all the work on the inside.
Well, that's fantastic. Now, how about we're sitting under an awning. Is this a Thule?
I'm not sure what the name brand of it is.
Did you have it installed?
It was installed when I put the windows on it.
Okay. So you had somebody put the window on?
Where I ordered the trailer from, yes.
And
it's a snapper trailer made by Diamond Cargo.
Okay. Great.
And I didn't want it as tall as it is, but when they told me I had to go 6 inches higher than I actually am to put the awning on it, I said, well, I want the awning on it. So they made the trailer 6 inches taller than what I actually wanted. I only wanted 6 foot, but it's 6'6".
Oh, so this is a custom-built trailer.
It is a custom-built trailer. I ordered it special.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
Fantastic. And it's just you and Carol. Any pets? No dogs?
I got a dog. She's going to start going with us. Matter of fact, I had to have the topper put on my truck so that the dog could ride in the truck with us.
Okay.
Okay. She's too big to go in the front with us.
Okay, so you're on one salary now. Is that Carol's?
That's Carol's income, yeah.
But you mentioned that you do something part-time, and that
I work every once in a while with my son-in-law. He started his own handyman business, so I've helped him get it started.
But you did something. You do something else? You are an
I work at the pastor. I work with my pastor, an elder at the church.
Okay, good.
And when he needs assistance and he's going to go on vacation or whatever, I fill in the pulpit for him or whatever the church needs.
Good, good. That's great. All right, well, you ready to take a walk inside?
Sure, I'd be
now,
glad to.
Let's do this. Let's walk around the outside, and then is there some special stuff you want to show us inside?
Whatever.
Okay.
There's nothing. Cabinets he made and things like that.
He built it all.
Yeah.
Wow, fantastic.
On the inside, yes.
Okay, all right, great. All right, let's change the camera here and take a walk around the outside.
Sure.
Okay.
Tell me about it.
It's a 6x12 diamond cargo trailer.
Diamond cargo?
Yeah, it was made by Snapper.
Okay.
Ordered it through Snapper Trailers.
Okay.
I had a camper door put on the side and a camper door put in the rear. We'll look at it in a moment. It's just a regular old cargo trailer on the outside. And
okay. They put the door in for you.
They put the... It comes with a camper door that's narrower, but I ordered a little wider door.
Okay.
Because I wanted to be able to get in and out of it a little easier with stuff. The awning was put on by them when I ordered it, and the camper windows
and
were
the camper
put in
windows,
it.
Yeah.
The camper windows were put in. They just slide back and forth there. You'll see on the inside, they're about halfway between the cabinets that I built to go in it and the bed, the top of the bed, so that you get a good breeze across the bed.
Okay, so you picked the height of the windows so you could get a breeze over them.
Yeah, I special ordered the windows at a certain height so that when I built the bed, there would be a breeze across the bed with the windows open.
Cool. Let's go around the back. Okay.
When I ordered a trailer, most cargo trailers come with a ramp in them. I didn't want a ramp on it. And if they have barn doors on the back of them, I told the guys, no, I don't want barn doors either. I just want one door.
One door.
On one side. So that I could put a window unit on the opposite side of the door.
And how do you power that window unit?
Everything's electric on the inside. It's all 110. Then electric with three different breakers. One serves the air conditioner, one serves the plugs, and one serves the microwave and a plug in the kitchen area.
Fantastic.
So the one door's total height, so when you come in, you actually have an emergency exit from the inside and there's storage space underneath. So there's a lot of storage space under there. It goes all the way to the front of a queen size bed.
Okay. When she brings the little camera back, we'll get some other shots of that. And tell me about the storage underneath.
The storage under the bed, there's plenty of room for all your camping stuff, tables, stoves, my spare tires under here,
an axe,
a shovel for the, a box over there.
It goes way back under there.
It goes way up in there. It's a regular queen size bed. So the depth of this goes all the way to the front of the bed.
Holy smokes. Well, we'll shoot this with a little camera because it'll pick it up better.
Yeah, and this that you're seeing here is just the back of cabinet storage.
Okay.
Over the bed.
Wow.
And then there's a box on the inside when you see it. It's just framed around the air conditioner to give it a more finished look instead of just looking at an air conditioner.
Yeah. Who mounted that? You?
I did. Yeah.
Wow.
I mounted this. My son-in-law, when I first brought it home, I said, all right, let's ruin the warranty. We took a sawzall to the thing and just cut a hole in it. That ruined the warranty. He said, if you start messing with it, you're cutting holes in it.
That's it.
Get away with the warranty. on the side over here, I don't know if you're going to be able to see it.
Yeah, no,
over
I'll
here.
Come around there.
On the inside, there is a small portlet, a porta potty that sits right here, and it's like a little bathroom area.
Okay.
There's a breaker box right on the side of one of the walls that 110 goes into. So I have the whole camper is 110. It runs right off of any camper plug when you bring it into a campsite.
Nice.
So
nice.
That's where the power comes in. And then on the front side, there's water that services it on this side, right under a sink. And then inside I took 4-inch PVC pipe and made a holding tank that's under the sink. It holds about 5 gallons of water. Run the water from here, and then this is a dump area to dump the gray water from the sink.
Oh, that's a gray water dump. What a clever idea that is.
So that way, you know, at nighttime, you have to use the bathroom, you potty. There's a little porta potty. You have a sink, or if you want to, just an overnight trip, you can sink bath.
Yeah.
Instead of having to go, if you go to a campsite that doesn't have showers and stuff.
Yeah. Now, tell me about that ball protector.
This hitch is on here. My son-in-law suggested I get it so that if someone can't just pull in and hook to my trailer and take off with it.
Yeah, that's right.
So it's got a ball hitch on it that it just locks on there like a regular camper ball would, or any trailer ball.
And we have diamond plate here in the front?
It's all diamond plate across the front for a rock guard. And of course, you see it's made by Snapper Trailers Diamond Cargo.
That's cool. Okay, and we got a TV antenna over here.
There is a TV in it. There's antenna on it so that you can have regular aerial antenna. You know, everybody has those antennas. You get free TV that way. But you can also hook to the cable on the top for if you have a campsite that has cable TV.
Cable, yeah.
Or inside the back of the TV has, we have a Fire Stick in there right now. It runs off the internet. That if you have Wi-Fi, you can use the internet, the Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
Or Apple TV. My son-in-law used it a couple weeks ago the first time.
And he used the Apple TV?
He used Apple TV.
He must be a millennial.
He is. Go. So we can go on a tour on the inside here.
Okay, we got hydraulic chairs, too.
Holy yeah, I have a
hydraulic chair.
That's for me. We went to a camp show, and I fell in love with the chair, and they got this for me for... Christmas.
Wait a second. Tell me about those hydraulic rockers.
I fell in love with it at a camper show in Tampa at the fairgrounds, and my son-in-law and daughter and my wife, they all got together to get me this because I had to have it. I gotta have one of those.
Yeah, I don't blame you. I think I gotta have one too. All right, so we're gonna go around here, and
most trailers come with a levelers, the trailer levelers. Well, I was worried about dragging them off over humps and stuff, so those are just bought from Harbor Freight. They're just regular car jacks. And I have I'll show you, to raise it up and down, I just took and cut the end off and put that on there to raise it up and down. So it just goes in the, to go up or down.
Fantastic. You're a pretty clever guy.
So that way they're not permanently fixed to the camper. In case you go over something where the back of the camper comes down, it'll drag them off. That's what I was worried about there.
Okay, let's go inside.
And another thing that campers have is steps. I was worried about having a mounted step that would get drug off, so I just made a wooden step to step up on to go inside with.
Okay.
So my wife doesn't break her ankle when she's going in and out.
That's good. Okay.
And if we come in, this is the kitchenette area. You come in, has hot and cold water. Under the sink, we'll see here in a few minutes, is an on-demand water heater instead of a water heater being in here. On this side, I just put a cooler. Carries all your cold stuff and things like that. And then there's places for dishes back in the back there. And then overhead we have a microwave. We have a microwave overhead with cabinets that hold storage, groceries and things like that.
Yeah, very clever. Let's take a look at that sink. Very nice.
I don't know if this camera will pick it up or not, the hot water heater, the on-demand hot water heater underneath.
Let's see what we got here.
Which is on a switch so that when I don't have water hooked to it, I turn it off so that it doesn't burn, the elements won't burn up if you don't have water in it.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Tell you what. All right, so.
So as you come in, This is I built a closet area for hanging clothes with three drawers underneath of it. And of course my wife has to have a little porta potty in case she goes in the middle of the night.
Yeah. Yeah.
Medicine cabinet with a mirror. And I got stuff falling out of it, which is fine.
Yeah. Well, that's part of traveling.
That's right. And
a little first aid kit.
First aid kit above it in case, you know, it just got some boards on either side of it to keep it from sliding off. It just sits up there and travel and the mirror keeps it on.
Okay, now is there a light in here?
There is a light right here over top. It works off. It's all 110. There's a light also underneath the, over the sink.
Okay. Let's see, that's right there. Whoops. Okay.
And then in travel to keep the medicine cabinet shut, I just put a hook on it.
Fantastic.
And that just keeps it from flying open. That works off of the parking lights on the truck.
Okay.
If you're traveling, you can come in here and that works off the parking lot of the truck.
Okay, great. We got a queen size
and
bed.
And then we have it's a full queen size bed with a full mattress on it. It's not a regular camp mattress. It's come out of my house and we replaced our house mattress. Cabinets for storage built all over top of the bed so that you can have plenty of storage area.
Now, is there insulation in the walls?
I did not put insulation in the walls. That's one thing that I probably, in hindsight, would go back and pull all of the paneling off and put insulation. But the small area we have here, this little air conditioner heats it well. And then I have an electric heater. We did use it two nights ago because it was cool in the morning.
Yeah, it was.
And I'm going to get a propane heater in case you go camping where there's no power and stuff like that.
Now, do you have to vent the propane heater?
No, it's a like a Coleman.
There's a little cylinder.
Little buddy heater. It's
yeah.
Like, you see them at Walmart.
Yeah.
And they can just sit right here on the counter and heat the place up, and it don't have to be vented. It
doesn't have to be vented.
No.
Okay.
No, it's fine.
Okay, and back there is your, there's your air conditioner.
Yeah, there's not a lot of light back in that area back there. But,
and there's your side window.
Those windows, I'll see if I can pull one of the windows apart so you can see it now. We like it dark, so I put curtains here, but I also put a darkening area back there. But the windows are there. They slide open so that you can have cross ventilation.
Yeah. Very cool.
And in the back, here in the back, you can see it in a few minutes, there's a plug with USB plug in it to charge your phone or put your computer. My wife likes to sit with her computer at nighttime and work on that.
Very cool. Open the other window for me, would you? Okay.
That window opens that way.
And
over the bed, we have a TV.
The requisite TV.
Which it's hooked up to an aerial antenna right now. Uh-huh. But most TVs now have inputs in the back for Bluetooth, Apple TV. There's a little shelf up here for the little Apple device sets on it, or a DVD player.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, last night my wife used her phone as a hotspot, and we set it up here. And used it.
And then what'd you connect to the phone?
She has internet on the phone.
Yeah.
And we just watched a movie over the
TV. I mean, how did you connect the phone?
It just hooks right into the back of the TV. She's got a cable that hooks into the back of the
TV.
Oh,
okay.
I have to get her to show you that. But she has a cable that hooks to her phone, and then it hooks to the TV as an app. Like, it's just like a
Roku or anything?
Yeah. And in the back of the TV right now, we have a Fire Stick, which is... works off of internet, but there's no internet service here anywhere, no Wi-Fi.
Yeah, you have to get it off your phone.
But on both sides of the bed, there's one of those plugs for, so she can have her plug. And one thing that I didn't have that you can tell right now is there's no lights in the back. She likes to read at night.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put up here a night light, some kind of a small reading light for her to sit and read at nighttime. Got storage up here.
Okay. Yep, and window unit.
And there's a regular small window unit that I bought from Walmart, and there's cabinets up here.
A lot of storage.
Lots and lots of storage.
Yep. Okay, cool. We got a full bed.
Full bed.
Is that a drawer?
Yes.
Pull out?
There's a drawer here.
Wow. Look at that.
It's just the right size for two people, isn't it?
That's right. And over top, there's an overhead vent that we don't like the light coming in, but it's covered up right now with a piece of cardboard. But it does, it's a, there's a vent here. That opens and shuts. It's a regular vent like any other camper has. But we like it dark. We like to keep it dark. So that's what this is on here for.
Okay.
Well, you've got a beautiful trailer here. Thank you so much for taking the time and letting us invade your privacy.
Oh,
and
thank you. I'm pretty proud of it. There were things that I would change if I had to do it over again. I would probably get a little longer trailer, dual axle, where I could put a refrigerator in it instead of a cooler, and it would be a gas and a electric refrigerator, like in most campers,
yeah,
so that
right.
you could travel with it on.
Right.
And maybe would put a full bathroom and shower in.
Yeah. But, well, at these state parks, you know, the facilities are so nice, and they're just
They're just
50
right
yards.
Yeah, you don't really
so,
need that.
No, we
so.
We our ours is we're the third owner, and I think the toilet's been used one time for number two out of three owners, because you have these places, you know, you just don't need it.
No.
Right.
That's
right.
it. You
and,
don't.
And it takes up a lot of space.
Right.
So. Well, they one last question, Carol. Everybody names their units.
Oh, goodness.
Have you been thinking of a name?
Not yet.
No.
It took me a long time to think of the name of my car, so.
Oh, yeah. You named your car?
Yes.
And what's the name of your car?
My car is Alice.
Alice, is this Alice?
No, that's not
my
Alice.
Truck.
That's my truck.
And does the truck have a name?
No, the truck doesn't have a name.
No, I don't
just
think.
Yeah, hunting. Burning. It does have a hunting. Yeah. It goes hunting all the time.
Does it really?
Oh, yeah, I love to hunt, so.
Well, thank you so much.
Well, thank you, Richard.
You
I
have
sure
a wonderful
it.
Time.
Thank you very much.
Nice to meet you. How
nice
long
are
you staying in the park?
We leave in the morning.
Oh, okay.
So we're headed home back to Tampa in the morning. We were here since Sunday evening.
You have 2.5 acres in Tampa?
Zephyr Hills, north of Tampa.
Oh, yeah. Zephyr Hills.
Zephyr Hills. Where do you get your water from?
Where Nestle Waters gets their water from.
Yeah, that's true, too.
Nestle changed to Nestle.
They're both bottled in the same plant. Right down the road from the house.
So. They're on a mission to get all of the Florida spring water.
Yeah.
Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
They've just they're pumping 3 million gallons a day out, and they've just put in a request to get 1.15 million gallons a day out of Jenny Springs.
Wow.
So they're here to take your water.
Yeah, I'm sure they are. And they will be pulling mine because I run off of a well.
Yeah, we do too.
That's where it would come from. I'd be a little bit upset if that happened.
Well, thanks so much. And
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you might consider subscribing so you don't miss other ones. And give us a thumbs up down below. Really appreciate it. Till the next video, have a great afternoon.
Thank you.
All right.
Okay, now show me the...